Murray. I'm a former British ambassador, and I've come along because this action by Israel is completely illegal. You can't board the vessel of another state in international waters. That's an act of war, in fact, by Israel against Turkey in this case. I think the time has really come when the British government has to stop tolerating this kind of atrocity by Israel.
And so you've had a look at the events of last night, 20 people were killed, and you're saying that it was an illegal boarding of the ship in international waters.
That's right.
Yes.
The vessel was on the high seas. Any point beyond 12 nautical miles from the nearest coast is the high seas. No state can board the vessel of any other state inside the high seas. It's merely a freedom of navigation. So there's no doubt at all that as a matter of international law, this was illegal. It was an illegal attack. A Turkish flag vessel on the high seas counts as Turkish territory, and Turkish law applies. So the people who killed the demonstrators should be tried for murder in Turkey.
And so what would you say about Israel's claim that they acted in self-defense?
Plainly, they were not under attack from this convoy. It wasn't carrying any arms and it wasn't firing on anybody. So I think the propaganda we've seen coming out of Israel has fallen back on the Goebbels' big lie technique. It has been so breathtaking in its arrogance and its disregard for the truth. I find it quite hard to believe, but serious broadcasters are covering it.
And, do you see similarities between the propaganda they're putting out now and the propaganda they put out during Operation Cast Lead?
I think that has to be true. I mean, we know, for example, over the use of white phosphorus, that they lie about things all the time. And I do think they've been rumbled by the vast majority of the public. The sad thing is they haven't been rumbled by the media establishment, or the media establishment doesn't really care about the truth, and neither do most of our politicians.
Why do you think that the media is giving Israel such an easy ride in the press?
I think it comes down to the political and financial influence of the Zionist lobby. You know, there's no point pretending it doesn't exist. There's an extremely strong lobby for the State of Israel. That lobby is very well funded, it has very good media access and a lot of influence over a lot of politicians. So it has an ability, through the sheer force of cash, to set the terms of debate. And there's no, sadly, no coordinated attempt by the Islamic world to use its money to counter that.
And what would you like to see the British government do now?
I think the British government needs to come out with a strong condemnation of this illegal Israeli attack. I should say I'm a member of the Liberal Democratic Party, and we're part of a governing coalition, and it's a great matter of shame to me that the government hasn't issued a straightforward condemnation of what's happened. That has to be the first place. After that, we look at sanctions against Israel.
And importantly, Nick Clegg last year came out and spoke out against the inhumane siege. How do you think the coalition will deal with that? And obviously, respect Nick Clegg's statement in relation to the siege.
Oh, I have no doubt at all that there are some rather difficult negotiations going on between the Lib Dems and the Conservatives at the moment as to the line the coalition will take, with the Conservatives being more actively pro-Israel. But we'll see what the government comes out with. But I think pure humanitarian instinct should lead to a condemnation of it. This is something nobody can possibly justify. I think we'll leave it there, sir.
Lovely. Thank you very much.